Jamaica's agricultural sector plays an important role in contributing to food security and is largely dominated by small farmer families. St. Elizabeth, known as the breadbasket parish, is a source for vegetables and grown provisions for the island. Small farmers from the breadbasket are important producers of escallion and other crops. St. Elizabeth contributes 20 to 25% of all the local foods consumed in Jamaica. But recently, the beet armyworm has been plaguing many escallion and onion farmers in Jamaica. It has been around for many years, as a matter of fact, dating back to the 1970s on legumes. The first report of beet armyworms in Jamaica on escallion was made in the 1990s. It originated in Southeast Asia. The beet armyworm is a serious pest on over 90 plant hosts, including weeds, trees, grasses, and field crops worldwide. The damage resulting from beet armyworm infestation since 2009 is estimated at over $150 million, with damage done to over 200 hectares of escallion and onion. One thing we know for sure, the beet armyworm is a pest that is extremely difficult to manage, whether here in Jamaica or wherever in the world you find it. We're here at the Bodles Research Station of the Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries, and we want to find out more about this beet armyworm. So we'll be speaking with Plant Protection Officer, Mr. Warrell Dietrich. Let's investigate. So Mr. Dietrich, what exactly is the beet armyworm?
Well, the beet armyworm is an agricultural insect pest. It belongs to a specific group of moths, where the caterpillars are known as armyworms. The beet armyworm begins life as cylindrical eggs, greenish to white in color, covered with whitish scales with a cotton appearance, and contains from 50 to 150 eggs. Tiny armyworms hatch from these eggs within 2 to 3 days. The younger armyworms are pale green or yellow in color, while the older armyworms are darker and have a dark lateral stripe. The cocoon pupa is light to dark brown in color and is found in the soil. The adult emerges after approximately 6 to 7 days. Its forewings are mottled gray and brown, normally with an irregular banding pattern and a light-colored bean-shaped spot.
How does this affect the plant?
The beet armyworm feeds on the leaves of scallion and onion and skeletonizes it. As they grow older, they bore large irregular shape in the leaves and produce a lot of fruit.
Apart from onion and its scallion, what other plants do they eat?
The beet armyworm feeds on a wide variety of agricultural crops, such as callaloo, broccoli, cabbage, celery, corn, cowpea, lettuce, pepper, Irish potato, sweet potato, tomato, turnip, cotton, peanut, sorghum, soya bean, tobacco, and melon.
What causes the beet armyworm outbreak? Let's ask the farmers.
Beet armyworm is caused by the bat that lay the eggs on the leaf of the plant. And this is how we have the outbreak.
What I noticed with the worms is that after you have a long period of drought, when the rain starts falling, as soon as the leaves start to spring up, they can notice there's worms in it.
Well, the outbreak, if you have neighbors, like farmers around you, and them don't scout, it would get you in trouble, because they will left that field and come on your field, no matter how you try to pick and spray. If they don't scout, just like you, that's what gonna happen. That's why you, when you tell them, scout and spray, man, pick and spray. You have some people say it doesn't make sense, but it makes sense.
What are some of the factors contributing to the outbreak of the beet armyworm in Jamaica? Let's ask our RADA representatives.
There are multiple factors that causes the outbreak of the beet armyworm on an annual basis. Scallion itself is treated as a primary crop in southern St. Elizabeth and it is grown all year round. Also, the terrain contributes to the continuous outbreak of the beet armyworm and also the cultural practices. St. Elizabeth is known to receive little rainfall per annum and this is also a contributory factor of the persistency of the beet armyworm in the area. The choice of variety of the scallion that is grown, most farmers choose the evergreen hardy, which is more susceptible to the beet armyworm. Also, guinea grass is grown extensively throughout the area for use as mulch and becomes a favorable host after the rainy season, which is between April, May, and August and September, where extensive flush becomes suitable for the beet armyworm development. Under these conditions, beet armyworm migrates to the scallion and onion fields, causes devastation as the larvae migrate in large numbers at night. During the day, they continue destruction of the crops and may hide underneath the grass, mulch, or other debris and attack other crops. So most of the time, these are a few of the reasons that causes the outbreak within the area itself.
The poor use of insecticides is also a big problem, where some farmers misuse and overuse insecticides. For example, some farmers mix the spray too strong or too weak, and this can cause a lot of problems. In addition, some of the insecticides that are very effective, farmers are having difficulty to buy these insecticides because the costs of these insecticides are high. Proper field sanitation is also another big concern, especially in the trimming era where the scallion is trimmed or cleaned for the market. After these leaves, infested leaves are taken off, they are left there on the ground, and the beet armyworm, because of how it survives, then it will continue the cycle, and from there the pest can also build up and spread to other scallion fields.
Other practices which make the problem worse include climate change, evident by reduced rainfall and increased day temperatures and longer periods of drought. These favor the development of the beet armyworm and make the problem worse. Such conditions exist to a large extent in the areas such as Pedro Plains and Flagerman in St. Elizabeth. High cost of insecticides prevents farmers from using recommended and more effective chemicals throughout the crop cycle. The lack of community approach to management of beet armyworm. And low market prices for onion and escallion often results in reduced care of fields and favor pest outbreaks. So in summary, the year-round production of escallion. 2,
lack of adoption of an integrated pest management program by farmers and market price below production costs all contribute to the presence and buildup of the beet armyworm.
This is further compounded by the effects of climate change. Let's find out how these farmers are managing this beet armyworm problem.
The beet armyworm, if you don't get control of them, they will take you down. What I do, I pick, I spray, and I set some traps there. In the traps, you might see them, some people will call them flies, but they are mats. They are the ones who lay the eggs on the tip of the scallion. And in 3 days, you will have an outbreak.
Why other people have all these problems? It's like them spray them own. And through the chemical, it bring heat, and that hatch the egg them. My worm, I never spray it. Because my friend come to me and say, he call me Yuji. Say, Yuji, me have a salagyard, and I spray the salagyard. A little bit of spray leave, and I go put it on the scallion. See, the next morning, when I wake up and put my hand on my head, not even one piece we cook. From there, so I learn my knowledge and experience after it. Some minute I spray my own. And if they here last year, Mr. Bradshaw could tell you, it's pretty. Everybody eat down, my own never eat down. And the help of the trap, very useful to me.
If you have irrigation, then the bat is not able to lay the egg and the scallion leaf. It's better to control the bat itself than to control the worm. It's easier.
What I do to try and control the worm, I do spraying, hand plucking. If it's enough to reap, I try and take out as much as I can by taking out the ones that are mostly infested with the worms.
This thing come up to me to plant thyme in my scallion. So eventually, when I plant the thyme in my scallion, I get a better result with the thyme in the scallion. It goes and goes and goes and goes, tell me to see no more beet armyworm in my scallion.
While farmers may have their own experiences and approaches to managing this pest, the problem still remains. The current management approach on an individual basis has proven to be ineffective, as abandoned and poorly managed fields can become sources of reinfestation for other fields under fairly good management. What exactly is IPM?
IPM is integrated pest management. It is the use of various management strategies that are used together in a field to keep pest levels low and below damage levels. These levels are important in terms of getting economic production for the farmers.
Based on the difficulty in sustainable management of the beet armyworm, the Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries and the Food and Agriculture Organization have embarked on a technical cooperation program, TCP, valued at US$213,000. The two-year project has as its main objective, one, to strengthen the monitoring and surveillance program for the beet armyworm and establish and institutionalize a monitoring tool in appropriate agencies. Number two, strengthen on-farm crop pest management practices. Under this component, 20 farmers will be trained as beet armyworm management trainers of trainers, TOT, using the Farmer Field School, FFS, methodology. A more participatory approach to traditional training. These TOT farmers would then train 150 farmers in a similar Farmer Field School setting.
The Farmer Field School methodology is perfect from where I stand. It goes through the process as if it was ABC, taking you from the point of what you expect to what will eventually be your goal. I am completely satisfied.
Number three, broaden and strengthen the National Crop Pest Management Program. This will improve and sustain vegetable crop production through economically effective and sustainable management of beet armyworm populations. The project will require cooperation among all stakeholders, farmers, extension officers, community members, to monitor and timely implement the components of an integrated pest management IPM program on an area-wide basis. The specifics of the program are as follows. The first thing to do in an IPM program is to monitor the beet armyworm presence and population levels. Scouting at regular intervals and the use of pheromone traps will guide the management strategy to be employed. Observation of 5 armyworms in 25 plants warrants immediate action. This action could be a combination of physical, biological, cultural, and chemical intervention. The use of clean, uninfested planting material is highly recommended.
New fields should not be established in neighboring old and abandoned fields. It is also advised that wild callaloo and cotton, alternate hosts for the pests, should also be removed. For existing crops, remove infested planting material. Good field sanitation is paramount for both new and older fields. Healthy plants are better able to withstand pest pressure. Thus, a good fertilization program and timely irrigation are important. Remove eggs and caterpillars from escallion plants and destroy. This includes removal from outer and inner surfaces of leaves and may require clipping of leaves. This is only practical on small acreages with low beet armyworm population. Biological control. Numerous natural enemies such as wasps, plant bugs, beetles, spiders, and birds feed on the beet armyworm larvae and adult. It has been observed in South St. Elizabeth that the paper wasp is abundant during the cooler months and have been observed cutting the escallion leaves and removing larvae. Chemical control. Timing of applications is key to chemical control. Target very young armyworms. Choose environmentally friendly insecticides approved for use on onion and escallion, which are not as harsh on the natural enemies, including products with BTS abamectin. The application of pesticides must be done safely to protect farmer and environment health and to maximize effectiveness. Although chemical control may be part of an IPM program, it should be used after other strategies have been employed. Use chemical control as a last resort. Calendar spraying is not advised and should not be a normal practice. Post-harvest management. All trash and debris should be removed from harvested escallion and onion stations into plastic bags or onto tarpaulins to be sunned or destroyed after the cleaning process is completed. Any armyworms present within the trash may migrate to adjacent fields and pupate in the soil to later emerge as adults and migrate to nearby fields. Management of cleaning station. The role of the escallion cleaning station should not be ignored as they serve as a constant reservoir for beet armyworms. These stations should be properly managed by destroying plant residues after each cleaning operation. This should be a community effort. Work being validated under the FAO BAW TCP include trenches. Digging trenches is a traditionally effective method used in Africa. This is done when guinea grass is flushing extensively and infestation of beet armyworm is detected on the leaves or on the debris. Trenches are 30 centimeters, that's about 1 foot deep, with vertical sides. Migrating worms may fall into trenches and are unable to climb out and are also accessible to cattle egrets, the birds we call garlin, so they feed on them. Intercropping with thyme. Thyme can be grown in alternating rows with escallion and onion. Thyme has an active ingredient named thymol, which has repellent properties for many moth species by preventing oviposition. The forecasting system involves farmers working in collaboration with extension officers to provide information on the population of beet armyworm to forecasters, who also use climatic data such as temperature, rainfall, and relative humidity data to predict when outbreaks will most likely occur. Other areas to be investigated include the use of light traps to disrupt mating. The dreaded beet armyworm can be managed, but it will require the cooperation of farmers, buyers, vendors, and other stakeholders. Number one, follow the recommended management strategies. Number two, farmers in affected areas and surrounding areas need to cooperate. Number three, be your brother's keeper. United we stand, divided we fall. Four, the beet armyworm is no respecter of person, regardless of race, color, financial status, or affiliation. We all have to form our own army in order to beat this army of worms. So now that we know what to do, make we manage it now. Together, we can beat this armyworm problem.